Yes, can you see screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you for that. There was a technical problem. Okay. So, we are discussing about that is elimination reaction, and today we'll discuss about orientation and reactivity in E2. So last time we have discussed E2 mechanism and mechanism with units. So today we'll see about the orientation and reactivity in E2 reaction mechanism. So here we have already seen that the mechanism of action, suppose if you take such type of substrate, that is R, here is a CH, here is also H, is a S2 and X in general, and this X may be orine, maybe chlorine, maybe bromine or iodine, alkyl halide, or maybe anything, methyl ethyl, phenyl nucleus. So the reaction takes place in the presence of base, and it undergo E2 mechanism. So there you have seen that the bond between the C alpha and here is a C beta. So this sigma bond between the C alpha and X will open on X negative and C positive. At the same time, this will shift here. So there is a presence of a C beta H bond. And you are getting corresponding compound, that is R, here is a CH double bond CH2 plus B for base BH. So you are getting alkene, a new compound. So the substrate is alkyl halide. And you are getting corresponding alkene. So here you get corresponding alkene. Now look here. In this elimination reaction, there is a formation of a carbon-carbon double bond between C alpha and C beta. So here there is a removal of a C beta H bond, and there is a formation of a carbon-carbon double bond between C alpha and C beta. So this is the orientation. This is the orientation means where the there is a introduction of, where there is a formation of carbon-carbon double bond. So this is the orientation in the E2 reaction. This is the orientation in the E2 reaction. So this is alpha carbon and these are beta carbon atom. Of course, as there is presence of only one beta, so here only you are having only one compound, alpha carbon and beta carbon. Only one beta carbon is there, so there is a presence of only one type of beta hydrogens. They are involved into reaction. So this is the orientation of the reaction. Right? Example, we can see, we can write also example. Now, let us see next example. Suppose we are having a such type of example. I will take the same thing, R, there is a CH, here is the H, here is the, so in general CH, and suppose if I replace this X by chlorine, okay, and one of the hydrogen from this CH2, if I replace by CH3. So I can write this CH3 like this one, right? So again, here there is a also alpha carbon and beta carbon. So this carbon is directly attached to the functional group, that is a chlorine. So it is called as alpha carbon. This carbon is a beta carbon, and also this carbon is a beta carbon. So there is the presence of two beta carbon. So you can write this beta, and this is your beta dash, right? Beta dash, right? So beta carbon and a beta dash carbon. So there is the presence of two type of a beta hydrogen. Now this reaction further, when you treat with the base, then what happen? Again, there is a elimination reaction. So of course, in this case, the sigma bond between the C alpha and X or Cl undergo breaking. Chlorine is a more electronegative as compared to carbon. So this sigma bond will open on the chlorine. There's a formation of a Cl minus and a C positive. Now, next case, here when there is a breaking of bond between the C beta and H, then there is a formation of this compound RCH double bond CH and CH3. I write CH3 also, same thing. Okay, so there is a formation of bond between the C alpha and a C beta bond. But suppose if the bond between C alpha and Cl break, and if the sigma bond between the C beta dash and H break, then there is a formation of a new compound, and in this case you are getting R. Here is a CH2, here is a CH and CH2. So you are getting two compound, number one and number two, right? So also this carbon is alpha carbon. So here you can write alpha carbon. Here is your alpha carbon, and of course this is your beta carbon atom, and here is a beta dash. So you are removing either beta carbon, beta hydrogen, or beta dash hydrogen. Then question arises, either this one is a major or this is second is a major. So here you will see that there is a formation of two type of the compound, compound number one and compound number two. So bond of the current carbon double means the incoming carbon-carbon double bond form in this two compound, compound number one and compound number two, compound number one and compound number two, and you are getting a such type of two compound. So this is called as a orientation, raised by orientation. Orientation means it is the position of incoming carbon-carbon double bond in the alkene. When substrate, this is your substrate, this substrate will undergo, that is a elimination reaction. Here we say E2 elimination reaction. You know E2 elimination reaction means bond breaking and bond forming process takes place simultaneously. It is one step cell, so bond breaking and bond forming process takes place simultaneously, and you are having a such type of compound, right? So here we have to discuss either one is major or second is a major. So same thing we can say that by using example. So here experimentally is observed that this is your major and this is your minor. So the elimination is governed by a rule called as a Sergeyev rule. The elimination is governed by a rule called as a Sergeyev rule. So what is mean by Sergeyev rule? We have to see Sergeyev rule. So Sergeyev rule tells us that when elimination takes place, there is a formation of highly alkyl substituted alkene is a major compound. Highly alkyl means more alkyl. Substituted alkene. Alkene here, look here, there is a carbon-carbon double bond between C alpha and C beta. So, on the doubly bonded carbon atom, if there is a presence of a more alkyl group on the doubly bonded carbon atom, then it is a major compound. So here, let us see which is the major. Here you see that in the compound number one, you'll find that this is your doubly bonded carbon atom, C alpha and C beta. So to this carbon, there is a H and there is one R. There is a one R, right? At the same time, you'll find that the C alpha is directly attached to hydrogen, and this carbon means again there is a second R. So it is a dialkyl substituted. So this alkene is a dialkyl substituted alkene, right? But here you'll see that on the beta dash only there is a HH, and on the C alpha you are having this carbon, means this R is directly attached. So here only one R is directly attached. So it is a monoalkyl substituted alkene. So in first case, in the first product, there are two alkyl group directly attached to the doubly bonded carbon atom. And in the second case, there are only one alkyl group directly attached to the doubly bonded carbon atom. So Sirchev rule tells us that the elimination takes place in such a way that there is a formation of a highly alkyl substituted alkene is formed as major product. So these are major. Why? Because to the doubly bonded carbon atom, this one and this one means two alkyl group, they are directly attached. But in the second case, only one R is directly attached to the doubly bonded carbon atom. So major is the one and second is the minor. So in this case, actually we get the two compound, one and two. But in that case, again, one is major and the second is minor. So here, when it is to us, we write one and that time, how the second is, but if only down their compound, so here one is a major. So this elimination is governed by the rule is called as a Sirchev rule. Now let us see the example of this one. So example is also very easy. Just you can write R group, you can write number of examples. Suppose R is a methyl. The methyl, right? So second remaining parts remain same. Here is H, here is a CH2, and here is a, suppose if I take here bromine, chlorine, like this one, and next one is a CH3. So of course it is alpha carbon, this is your beta carbon, this also beta carbon, right? So just I write here to differentiate between the two beta carbon, beta and beta dash. It react with the base. You can write base like alcoholic KOH. So here if asked to write down only one compound, then you know that the bond between the C alpha and Br break. So it will break here, Br negative, C positive. Now question arises, either you have to break this beta hydrogen or this beta dash hydrogen. So when it asks to write down only one compound, that time you have to write that compound which is the major. So here you have to replace this major CH and CH3. So you are getting corresponding 2-butene. In 2-butene, there are two alkyl group directly attached. And if you replace this beta dash hydrogen, then you are getting CH3. Here is a CH2, here is a CH and CH2, means here is the carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, butane, when there is a carbon-carbon double bond. So it is a 1-butene. So it is a 1-butene. It is a 2-butene because 1, 2, 3, 4, there are the 4 carbon butane. At 2, there is the presence of a carbon-carbon double bond. So 2-butene. So there is a formation of 2 compound, 2-butene and 1-butene. So here, this 2-butene is a major. 2-butene is a major. So when you outright only one compound, then you outright only 2-butene. And when you outright the both compound, then you have to also write a minor compound. So the beta carbon atom have beta hydrogen, and you have to replace that beta hydrogen. Okay, so this is the another example. So in this way, we can write the number of example. So just I'm going to change the group. You are getting the number of example. Suppose here, if instead of the CH3, if I write that is a CH3 CH2, means I write one more carbon atom, so the remaining part becomes same, right? So here the CH3 becomes CH3 CH2. So just I will write one more example. CH3, here is a CH2, then CH, here is a H, and the CH. Suppose if I write here iodine, then in the presence of a base, so it is your alpha carbon, it is your beta carbon, it is your beta carbon. Look here, I am writing a bond between the carbon and iodine. I am not writing here and there, it is wrong. Here you have to write a bond between the carbon and hydrogen. I am not writing the bond between the this hydrogen and in between this carbon and H, it is wrong, right? And this CH3, this 3, this 2, they are to the base and all are capital. Okay, so the reaction takes place in the presence of base. We can write base sodium ethoxide also. NaOeT means sodium ethoxide. Again, same thing, a bond between the C alpha and iodine undergo breaking. So this is open here. There is a formation of a carbon. And this sigma bond will shift here. There is a formation of a carbon-carbon double bond. At the same time, this may be also shift here, and also there is a formation of carbon-carbon double bond. So here you are getting two compound, and with the major. Major is that which have highly alkyl substituted alkene. So here is a CH double bond, CH and CH3. Number one, right? So this is compound number one, and it is a major. It is a major compound. And what is the name of this compound? How many carbons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 means pentane, corresponding alkene, pentane. And add carbon number 2 and carbon number 3. There is the presence of a carbon-carbon double bond. So if you give the numbering from the right side, the doubly bonded carbon atom get the least number, so it is a 2-pentene. So it is a 2-pentene, right? ENE, pentene. These are alkene, pentene. At the same time, also you can get a minor compound where you replace this beta dash hydrogen atom, and you can get the next compound, that is a CH3, CH2, CH2, CH double bond CH2. So you get the second compound, and second compound is a minor. It is a minor. Its percent is a very, very less. Suppose first major is 80%, it is a 20%. You may also write 90% and 10%, right? And here the name of the compound is a 1-pentene. When you write any reaction, every time remember that below this one, you have to write the name of the compound. You have to make a habit of writing this name of the compound. So what is the name of this compound? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, pentane. At 2, there is iodine. So 2-iodopentane. So this compound is 2-iodopentane. This compound here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 2-4. Okay, so here you find that there is a formation of a corresponding alkene. So these are the examples. So here what you have learned, we have learned the orientation. What is the orientation of incoming carbon-carbon double bond, right? So we have seen the orientation. So orientation is governed by the Strzejew rule, right? So what is the Strzejew rule? We can explain the Strzejew rule in a such a way that when there is a elimination reaction, when there is a elimination reaction, the highly alkyl substituted alkene is formed as a major compound, major product is called as a Strzejew rule or Strzejew elimination. Right. So we have taken some example. In this way, we can write number of examples. Right. So even though we can also replace the hydrogen on the beta carbon and beta dash also by the alkyl group, and you can also get the number of example. Right. Now here we have seen that there is a formation of a highly alkyl substituted alkene as a major product, right? Means if there is a formation of a tetra, then tri, then di, and then mono alkyl substituted alkene, in that case we can say that tetra is a major, then the tri, right, then di, and then mono alkyl substituted alkene. So this is the sequence, right? So this is the major. Then here we say it is a major, tetra is a major, then the tri, then the di, and then the mono. Then also we have to give justification for the reaction, for the elimination. So you have to give the evidence for the this Strzejew elimination. Then you can say that there is a presence of formation of highly alkyl substituted alkene as a major product, right? So this called as a orientation. This is called as a orientation. And here we have seen some of the example, and we have learned the orientation by using the Strzejew elimination. If you have any doubt, you can ask us. यदि आपको कोई doubt है, तो आप पूछ सकते हो. You can ask any doubt if you are not getting. Yes. यदि कोई आपको doubt है, तो आप पूछ सकते हो. Question 19. So before starting a new point, it takes some more time. So instead of starting a new point, we'll discuss here. Yes. Any doubt? So what we have discussed, orientation and reactivity. In that one, we have taken orientation point. Orientation means what is the position of incoming carbon-carbon double bond, and it is governed by the Strzejew rule. What is Strzejew rule? The elimination takes place in a such a way that there is a formation of highly alkyl substituted alkene as a major product. In this case, in the first example, in this case only there is a presence of only one beta hydrogen atom, so that hydrogen undergo elimination and you are getting corresponding alkene, right? So in first case we cannot apply the Strzejew elimination, but in the second case we'll see that there is a presence of a beta and a beta dash hydrogen, so here it undergo elimination reaction. So we can remove either beta dash hydrogen or a beta hydrogen. If you remove the beta hydrogen, you will see that there is a formation of compound number one, in which to the doubly bonded carbon atom, alpha carbon and beta carbon atom, the alkyl group is directly attached. So it is a dialkyl substituted alkene. Whereas in the second compound, you'll find that only one R group is directly attached to the alpha carbon atom. So it is a monoalkyl substituted. So according to the Sergeyev rule, one is a major. Why? Because there are the two alkyl group directly attached to the doubly bonded carbon atom. So same thing we can explain by the example. So just I have replaced this R by methane. Remaining part is same, right? So 2-butene and 1-butene is formed by this reaction, and you can get a such type of a compound, right? Similarly, instead of methyl, I have put here ethyl. We can also replace the hydrogen on the beta carbon or a beta dash hydrogen. So it is say we can get number of example. So if there is a formation of a tetraalkyl, trialkyl or dialkyl or a monoalkyl, then tetra is a major, then the tri, then the di, and then the mono. So why tetra is a form, then the tri, then the di, and then the mono? Of course we use the Sergeyev rule. So Sergeyev rule tells us that the elimination takes place in a such a way that there is a formation of a highly alkyl substituted alkyl as a major product. But we have to see why tetra is a form of major, then the tri, then the di, and then the mono. So we have to give the justification for the Sergeyev rule. We have to give the evidence for the Sergeyev rule. So this point we'll take, that is a justification or the evidence for the Sergeyev rule in the next lecture, right? Always a question of 3 mark, they ask write down short notes on the Sergeyev rule. Only you have to write down the definition, and you can write any one example. You can write either in general example, or you can write also in particular. Even though we can make a number of example, just you replace the hydrogen on the beta and a beta dash, you can put any alkyl group, you get the number of example. So in the next lecture we will discuss about the justification